The new FDA guidance on cybersecurity is important for device manufacturers because it changes the way software is going to be developed for new medical devices and what documentation is expected from device manufacturers as part of a submission. My name is Russell Haley and I'd like to discuss this with you. The new FDA guidance on cybersecurity has three main focuses: to ensure that software security is included in all aspects of the software development lifecycle, ensure that an iterative approach to software security extends into the post-market maintenance, and provide better transparency to medical device stakeholders such as hospitals and service providers. What does this mean for device manufacturers? It means more emphasis on security documentation during the development phase, tracking software components and their vulnerabilities through software bill of materials, planning for post-market cybersecurity surveillance and ensuring there is a way to update software and patch vulnerabilities, and transparency, sharing cybersecurity and vulnerability information with other stakeholders. The FDA has embraced the concept of total product development lifecycle, which means some aspects of cybersecurity that were usually addressed in HIPAA have been brought forward and are now in the domain of device manufacturers. In the FDA's own words, the guidance document is applicable to devices with cybersecurity considerations, including but not limited to devices that have a device software function or that contain software, including firmware or programmable logic. The guidance is not limited to devices that are network enabled or contain other connected capabilities. The FDA suggests using a Secure Product Development Framework, or SPDF, to adopt an iterative, holistic approach to cybersecurity. The steps for an SPDF are reasonably well spelled out in the guidance and include threat modeling, cybersecurity risk analysis, documenting mitigations, and creating architectural outputs and diagrams that support security decisions. Again, to quote the FDA, one way these TPLC considerations for devices can be achieved is through the implementation and adoption of a Secure Product Development Framework. An SPDF, as described in this guidance, is a set of processes that reduce the number and severity of vulnerabilities in products throughout the device lifecycle. Further, when reviewing pre-market submissions, FDA intends to assess device cybersecurity based on a number of factors, including but not limited to the device's ability to provide and implement security objectives below throughout the device architecture. Next, for transparency, the FDA has mandated that all software components be documented in a Software Bill of Materials, or SBOM. There are two industry-supported formats for SBOMs, Cyclone DX and SPDX. These industry standards ensure there is a consistent way to document all software components so that the SBOM can be shared with other stakeholders. The SBOM can be used to identify and track vulnerabilities and depreciated packages that are part of the device. Finally, the FDA wants to ensure that cybersecurity is extended into post-market activities through Cybersecurity Management Plan. The Cybersecurity Management Plan documents how the device manufacturer will review the product for vulnerabilities and have a system in place for developing mitigations and rolling out patches to device stakeholders. There are many nuances and other aspects of the guidance that may be applicable to you as a device manufacturer, but the core concepts have been discussed here. I hope this video has helped you gain some understanding of what the FDA expects from device manufacturers that have software incorporated into their devices. To learn more about the FDA guidance on cybersecurity, please check out my blog,